Hey, welcome to the indexation lesson, and let's get straight into it. So what are we going to cover in this lesson? We're going to cover what does indexation mean? What does it mean to be indexed on Amazon? Also, we're going to go through some common problems with indexation, and I'll provide you with some solutions for these problems. And also I'll show you the way that I index my listing, the way I make it work. So it's going to be easier for you, and hopefully it's going to save you time and problems. Let's get into it. What we're going to be using in this lesson, we're going to be using Scribbles. Well, because technically from Scribbles, you're going to copy your listing to Amazon itself in order to fill the front end, the back end. And then we're gonna run the stuff that we have entered through Index Checker. Index Checker of Helium 10, and the Index Checker essentially allows you to understand if you're indexed or not. So what does it mean indexation? What does it mean to be indexed? So for example, we have a term kitchen knife. Somebody searches for kitchen knife on Amazon. And once somebody searches, he gets many, many different results, many, many different kitchen knives. These knives, or so to say, these ASINs that show up, they are relevant to the search term and they appear. That means they're indexed for this search term, kitchen knife. They're indexed. That means once somebody is searching for the term, it's gonna appear. Person that is searching is gonna see it, and he's able to then click on it and buy it. Now, sometimes when something is not indexing for you, people are gonna type in something that is present in your listing, but you are not gonna appear there. Now, appear doesn't mean page 1, 2, it can be page 15, 17, but still you will appear, you will be indexed. Well, we're gonna get to that in the problem section, but first let's start from taking the necessary steps in order not to get to that problem once you don't index. So how do we do that? So for example, if we have our listing ready here, we have everything filled. Imagine you have the bullet points done, the subject matters, description, the search terms. We're gonna first start from indexing front end. Before we index, we gotta actually copy the copy, right? The things that we created into Amazon. So for example, let's start from the title. Let's copy it. And in order to get there, we go to Amazon. In your inventory, you're gonna have a place to edit your product, so to say. It's gonna be a button to click. It's gonna click edit. You click on it, you're gonna get to this area, and you have the vital info. Vital info, you're gonna have to fill in the title here. The product name is your title. Now, Amazon states that it should be 250 characters. Now, usually it is less, like 200, but in some niches it can be even lower. How do you know? You gotta check it with Amazon. You gotta either go to Google, or not just Google, you can do it on the Amazon website, and just type in the search something like Amazon title recommendations or Amazon title requirements, and then it's gonna show up for you. Right now, if you don't know or you can't find it, you can always call them as well. You can call Amazon and ask them. So you, for example, you're getting into the specific category of baby headwear and you're not sure, you call them like, hey Amazon, like I'm getting into this category, like what is the necessary title required? It's gonna help you. If you don't know how to contact Amazon by phone or by email, I have a video that shows it exactly. I'm gonna link it up here and in the description down below, and there you'll understand how to contact them by phone. This is a very important video because you're gonna have to contact Amazon a lot, and if you're selling for a while, you know that you've probably been a while with them on the phone or through emails. So for example, our title here in the Scribbles, we have 150, and for example our category is fine with it. So we're gonna copy the product name here, and that's gonna be our title. The product name is essentially the title. Now you're gonna fill all the other stuff here. Sometimes Amazon is gonna add your brand name to your title. You can do it alone. So for example, if your brand name is called Superb, so then you're gonna have Superb Chef Knife Razor Sharp, but I recommend you not adding it initially because this is going to just save you some keyword space. But know that probably Amazon is going to add it to you, right? Then you input your brand name, manufacturer, all the other stuff. The next thing here is the category. Now it's interesting because you're going to be relevant here, and sometimes you will not be sure what exact category you need to be in. Well, check your competitors, check the competitors that are pretty much like you and see where they're selling at. You'll understand. Up here you're going to click on edit, and you're going to search. You can do it manually here, or you can search for a product's category. So if you type in kitchen knife, right, if your product is a kitchen knife, you click on find. You're gonna have many, many different categories here, and then you find the right one for yours. So for example, if you have box knife set, then you choose a box knife set for utility knife. So for example, I was gonna be chef's knife. You see home kitchen, kitchen dining, cutlery knife, etc. Chef's knives. All right, that's good for us. We're not an industrial scientific, and also we're not in food service equipment and supplies. Yes, we have chef's knives that are cutlery and knife accessories. We take this one. And of course, you gotta check what's relevant for you, what category is relevant for you, and then you choose it. You can fill the other things here. That's pretty much fine for our title. The title is going to be filled in here. So remember, our idea is to fill in the front end first, the title, the bullet, the description, and then only the back end. So we fill in the title, then we go next place, which is going to be here, the description. In the description, you will have to fill in the description, which Amazon recommends 2000 chars here. And remember, you have HTML here, the B and all the stuff. If you remember the copywriting lesson, the previous lesson, then there I showed you some examples of Diane, that the copywriter, how she uses it. And it's really nice because you can make something bold, can catch the eyes of of the customer. So if you create a beautiful description, this is the way you do it. But just remember that all these, they count towards the char's HTML description is gonna, with some specific, you know, bold or stuff like that, is gonna take a bit more space. Now here you copy your product description, right? And then the key features is the bullet points. One interesting thing to say here is that Amazon states 100 chars per line, and Helium 10 also states the same thing. Now from my experience, sometimes it's gonna index even more. So it's gonna index more than 100 chars. If you have a bullet that's 120, 150, it's still gonna index it. Again, I recommend you following the Amazon's guidelines. If they're saying 100, then probably better go with 100 per bullet point. They wanna make them short to the point. Now, once you copy your bullets here, tack, 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 5 bullets, description, we have the title ready. We're gonna click on save and finish. We're gonna click on save and finish here. And then we wait 15 minutes, let the system process our request. And then I'm gonna go to the index checker and work with it. How do we start working with the index checker? Well, we're gonna input your ASIN here. We're just gonna use this one for reference, for an example. But you input your ASIN here, you can input your seller ID as well. That's optional, as Helium 10 states is here as well. That's for the storefront index. And well, that's something that is not that needed, because you can technically get away with a traditional index and field ASIN index. That's gonna be enough for you. Now, again, what does it mean indexation? We gotta have everything in our listing. And then if we wanna appear in the search for it, we're gonna be indexed. And now we're gonna check actually if the system indexed us or not. And how do we do that? And what is a traditional index, field ASIN index? I'm gonna show it to you in a second. So let's imagine that that is your ASIN that you want to see if you're indexed for. And then we're gonna click on check keywords. Now, what kind of keywords do you wanna put in here? Well, you wanna go to Scribbles, or you wanna go back to your Excel table and copy all the keywords, all the phrases that are not for the back end. So not the Spanish, not the spelling mistakes, not competitor brand names, only copy whatever's gonna be on your front end. So essentially everything that's in your bullets, in the description, and in the title. Don't touch, you know, the back end for now. So if you go to Excel, we're gonna have the magnet keywords and the cerebral phrases. That's it. We don't need the others. Others we're gonna use once they're gonna be filled in the back end. And I usually take it one by one. So I start with the front end and then we go for the back end. Technically, you can fill everything in one shot and just click on submit. But from my experience, it just seems to not index that well. That's why I've come to a conclusion that it's better to do the front end first, and then I'll show you how to do the back end. You're gonna have to copy all of your phrases to this area. So for example, you have like all of these. Now, obviously some of these are not gonna, or not, this dude is not gonna rank for them because they're not that segmented well, because you have knee pads here and stuff like that. But for example, we had kitchen knife, knife, kitchen, bread knife, and some other stuff, and blah, blah. So what we do then, we click on check keywords. We can remove duplicates if something gets duplicated, like knife, and maintain phrases. In this example, it's gonna maintain the phrase. Bread knife is gonna stay bread knife. It's not gonna, it's the knife is not gonna get removed. Now let's see what happens. Once we click on check keywords, we have the relevant keyword for this ASIN, kitchen knife, knife kitchen, bread knife, and blah, blah. Now, as you can see, blah, blah is not showing a V here. That means it is not indexed, because, well, you don't have blah, blah probably in their listing, right? And our goal here with the index checker of Helium 10 is to get a V here in the cumulative. Okay, so that means if you get a green V here, that would mean that all the Vs here are gonna be ticked, so to say. And start from index does not tick because I didn't input the seller ID. It is not that important, but you can do that optionally. So you're gonna input the seller ID of yourself, or in this example of this knife, and then it would appear here as a V if it does index for the storefront, and then the cumulative would be green. But it's definitely enough to have, so to say, two of these at least. That's fine. Like traditional and field ASIN is awesome. Now, what does it mean? Like, how do we check it? So if you click on the V here, we have the kitchen knife and the traditional index for this ASIN. We click, and then it's going to show you on Amazon the results. So you see, this is the traditional index check. So you're going to check the ASIN plus the keyword. So this is the ASIN and the keyword is kitchen knife, and you have one result for this ASIN kitchen knife. Let me show it to you. There it is. Others are going to be sponsored here. As you can see, there are many sponsored products here, but this one is showing organically. That means that it is indexed. Next one, we have the field ASIN test. That's a bit of a different test. That's a URL kind of test, and we also can click on the V there. We're gonna find the keyword here, the kitchen knife, and the ASIN. That's the field ASIN check. If it appears here, that means it is indexed, right? You can just reassure by clicking here. And if it won't be, it would be an X, right? That's, again, here it shows an X because we didn't input the seller ID. You're gonna have obviously all of your keywords in here, and you're gonna see what indexes and what doesn't, right? So I can change essentially places for the specific keyword. I can put it inside another bullet, or I can put it in the different place in the description. This is the way for me to overcome a problem when something does not index in the front end. Usually, if you are relevant, if the keyword research was done well, you will index the front end like this, no problem. Really, there should be no reason. Again, if you are relevant, then it will index. If you have input some irrelevant keyword, then yeah, maybe it will not work. Sometimes, for example, if the phrase is heavy duty, right, for your kitchen knife, then maybe heavy duty as a phrase will index, but heavy and duty will not index, right? That there's an option of this as well. I don't know why it works like this, but sometimes the phrase will get indexed, which is awesome for us, because for example, if we need heavy duty knife and this will index, but heavy and duty will show as not indexing. But again, if we have the heavy duty phrase index and that's what we're interested in, then it's completely fine, right? These are the common mistakes that can appear in the front end indexing. The next thing we do, we go to Scribbles, right? If we were to have the subject matter and the search terms, we'd go to Amazon, and here in the keywords, we have the subject matter and the search terms. And here we will input or our subject matter, tac, 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 and the search terms, the right way that I've explained in the copy lesson. Now, as you can see, there are some other fields here, intended use, target audience, other attributes. What is this? Like, how do we fill them up? Now, I'll link in the description of this video, a free webinar by Kevin King, which is the webinar for his course, The Freedom Ticket. Now, in this webinar, he explains some of these techniques of how to find, it's called the Bros Node. So to say, how to find the right keywords to input in the intended use and in some other places for your product. Now, the webinar is completely free. And if you're already a user of Helium 10, then you have the Freedom Ticket course as a part of your plan. If you are not yet part of Helium 10 and you're on the Platinum, Diamond, or Elite plans, then you should join, because you also get the Freedom Ticket course for free once you join. And I didn't mention that through this course, but well, this is so. I have some videos speaking about this. You can watch a video I'm going to link down in the description about the course, what is there. I explained everything, like what is included. And this is part of Helium 10 for you once you join. So that's pretty cool. But if you don't want to join, you should, because as you can see with this course, it's going to be much easier for you to create a bombarding listing. But you can just check the webinar, which is free anyway. Then you can find some other techniques. So I'll link it down there. But generally for us, we want to index the subject matter. And you can see what it gives is winter, summer, spring, Mother's Day. And this is not what I want to do. This is not what I do usually. For the subject matter, as I mentioned in the previous lesson, and for example, in the Scribbles here, I can dupe some keywords that I've created before, like chef knife, kitchen knife. Yes, I can do, you know, like, because the space here is limited by 50 per one, I can even input some brand name there, right? I can play with it. But the next thing is search terms here, right? This is where we have 250 chars in the Scribbles here, down here. Here it says, do not, you see, no repetition, no competitor brand names or ASINs. Now, as I've mentioned, the brand names of the competitors or ASINs of competitors is against US, so up to you to use it. And also repetition of keywords. So Amazon tells you in the search terms not to repeat, for example, if we have the kitchen knife as our product, we don't want to repeat kitchen knife here. Now, I would repeat it in the subject matter. Yes, that's what I usually do. But in the search terms, we don't want to repeat the terms again. So we would just input things like, let me go back to the Scribbles, you know, the Spanish keywords, some other keywords that we couldn't input into our listing. Again, as you remember, the idea is to have all the words or as much as we can that are relevant used inside the listing. So it was going to be in the back end, in the front end, yes, title, description, bullets, and the back end. Our idea is to fill everything. Everything is going to be crossed like this in order to be maximum relevant and maximum powerful with our keywords. And that's what we're going to do here. We're going to do the search terms, subject matter. Here we have the intended use. You can check whatever they're saying. So for example, if intended use is, let's say, travel or kitchen, the other thing would be for the knife, home, right? You're gonna use it like this. But if you wanna kind of go the next step with it, you can check out the techniques in this webinar. I think you're gonna like it. Usually you can even go fine with, you know, with just doing whatever it says here. Kitchen, indoor, home, travel, portable. Well, portable, not really. Kitchen, outdoor, indoor, indoor, outdoor. And then if you don't have something to add, you can just repeat a keyword. So for example, what was our keyword? Chef's knife, chef's knife. Yeah, you can do that as well. But again, check out the webinar by Kevin, see how he looks into that. That's the way I do it. Target audience as well. You know, for example, if it's for adults, unisex, or women, or guys, you know, help you with your relevance. We have finished setting it up. Now, what happens next? Like, how do we know if do we index the backend or not? So what I usually do in the backend, I would add in one line of subject matter. For example, yes, I would do one line, the 50 chars. I click on save and finish, and I wait some time. I see if it indexes. If it does, I go through index checker, I check. check it. Awesome. I go next, next, next until I finish all of them, just one by one. Experience showed that it's better and, so to say, easier and work much better. Now, sometimes the back end is not gonna index. How do we fix this? Well, in order to fix this, we can copy specific keywords in the back end. So, for example, if one keyword would be cuchillo de cocina, de cocina, for example, it would not index. That's the kitchen knife in Spanish. And for example, the cuchillo does not index for us. So what we can do is we can copy this one, take it to the bullet points, add it to one of the bullet points. We duplicate it technically with the bullet point. We duplicate the keyword that is in the back end with the front end, with the bullet point. For example, we add cuchillo just somewhere in the end of our bullet point. We wait 15 minutes again. And usually this one is gonna solve it. What I do after this, once it happens, once it is solved, I delete it from the front end, from the bullet, but leave it in the subject matter, for example. And well, it will save itself. It will appear as index. That's the little less known technique. Once you take the back end that doesn't index, add it to your front end, and you duplicate it technically, then you delete it in the front end, and you just leave it in the back end for yourself. And then, of course, you run it through the index checker again, one by one, each subject matter, and then the search terms, everything. You run here, you check out the traditional index. You're gonna see that the cumulative is gonna be, as it says here, gray area check mark is pretty fine. If you wanna use the seller ID as well, perfect. You're gonna have the storefront index as well. It's up to you as you wish. And then you're gonna have an index listing. That means that everything is now ready for your launch and you have finished with the creation of your listing and with the indexation of your listing. The idea is to get 100% index listing. Everything, every keyword you have, every phrase that is relevant. Of course, again, if you have heavy duty and that's the relevant phrase you need and heavy does not index, no problem. Yes, just make sure that it is relevant for you and all the heavy duty things and the keywords are relevant, good, and you're ready to roll and you're ready to battle on Amazon now. Check out this next video over here where we're gonna cover the pictures for our listing, which is a pretty cool video. There I'm gonna show you how to create awesome photography, what is there, what are kinds of photography there are, and you're gonna be pretty mind blown there. So see you there.